people are interested in opium stuff, of course. Sure. And a lot of people interested in the gaming things. Mm-hmm. I like this Fantan cover and wand because the reason it has buttons there, like look like our coat buttons, mm-hmm. is because
years upon years of culture and history at the Chinese Museum in Lytton, destroyed in last week's fire. What was once a place filled with artifacts tied to stories, now reduced to rubble. A post on the museum's Facebook page reads, "I am so saddened to say that the Lytton Chinese Museum was totally burned in the Lytton fire. The photo was taken by what used to be my son's house, and all that remains of the museum are the rock walls in the background." Dr. Henry Yu is a history professor at UBC.
The Lytton Museum, you could say, and as well as the Lytton Museum and Archives, which also burned down, they contain a lot of the records of that longer history, you know, the remnants of those peoples that used to be there and moved out.
Now, the Fandriches purchased that empty lot in Lytton in 1980. More than 30 years later, that would become the site by which to honor the Chinese people who came here to work on the railroads, to look for gold, and to become merchants.
Yu has been to the museum multiple times and says the work of Lorna and Bernie Fandrich was invaluable to many.
One of the reasons why I was up there a lot is because we were doing raft tours of a lot of the Chinese gold mining sites that were up and down the Fraser on the banks. And you had to go there by water. That's originally how, you know, the gold miners got there. And so it's one of the few ways you can still get there is by raft.
He says Lytton was one of the jumping off points that included nearby restaurants and hotels.
Yeah, these amazing gold mining sites. It's as if someone, you know, the miners just stepped off yesterday because it's a very dry area. Unfortunately, that's what led to the fire. And so there's not a lot of water erosion of these sites.
The Vancouver-based Chinese Canadian Museum says when the time comes, it's ready to help.
I think when Lorna, the community is ready to kind of consider, you know, what is it that they need, what is it they'd like to do. I think I can say that the Chinese Canadian Museum would stand ready to support and discuss.
Luckily, many of the artifacts lost were digitized, but Yu says it's not the same.
Once you're there, you feel like you're walking in the footsteps of your ancestors, and that is something you can't replace.
Until plans are set, this loss is being mourned by people right across the province. Many writing on the museum's Facebook page, they hope to one day visit Lytton and see a new version of the museum.
In Vancouver, Rhea Renouf, City News.